All right, hear me out on this one. I went to Harbor Freight yesterday, was gonna buy the cheaper engine hoist. They were out of stock. They had the more expensive one, but I was like, nah. Went back today, I was like, gotta get this done, let me buy the more expensive one, and get there, out of stock. Now they have one about 20, 30 minutes away. I'm not driving to go get that shit. So why don't I borrow Sketchy Roosters? Problem is, if I put it in the back of the Bronco tailgate is gonna get all fucked off because just it's not gonna work. So, don't have any choice. Gonna attempt to take it out by hand. I know I can lift the short block. It's not that heavy. Getting it out, it's got the trans input shaft and all that stuff. We'll see. I'm gonna run a time lapse. I might give up. I might not upload this. I might have to wait till I get an engine hoist, but regardless, I'm gonna give it a shot. I'm probably gonna get hurt. It's gonna be stupid, whatever. We'll find out. Let's go.
And now you're about to witness me wrestle this short block out of this pile of shit Ranger. I didn't know this was gonna work out or not. I just wanted to give it a shot. So decided to wrestle this thing out. There's quite a bit of room in the engine bay to stand and pull on stuff, so here I am wrestling it. And then at one point I called for reinforcements and didn't have any reinforcements in the area, so I said, you know what, I got this shit, hold on, let me go get my gloves. I put my gloves on, fucking air box for a while, or shadow, what do they call it, shadow boxing. I was shadow boxing off camera, and yeah, I got this deal out. So I don't know. Whoop. Well, your boy did it. Single-handedly. No engine hoist. Just engine back hoist. So as you can see here, I'm getting this thing blown apart. All the stuff that I need for the new short block is coming off. Knock sensors, PCV thingy. This is the alternator bracket, motor mount, oil filter mount, just whatever. Gonna blow this thing down right here, load it up in the box. Hopefully take it back for a core. And then start bolting the stuff on the new deal. Now when the new thing comes, or when it comes to putting a new engine in, I'm probably going to need a hand. I don't want to fuck that up. I didn't care about this one coming out. As you can see, this is that $120 eBay clutch. I mean, for only having 1,000 miles on it, I'm gonna say that it doesn't look the best. I mean, there's nothing like catastrophic, but it definitely looked like it had some heat in it, and it really didn't have any miles on it. So, but I'm not a clutch guy. I don't know how all that shit works. I don't know what's heat, what's not, what's good, what's bad.